Ah, I can read what this says now. But it's a name.
Air! Whoa! The name made it light up.
It's the name of one of the Valkyries. That's quite curious.
To the boat, we can either look for that special chisel now, or go exploring for a little while. I'm happy with whatever you want to do.
Okay, here we go!
Nightmares, ugh! What awful crap!
Needs your brother.
Above you, look out!
Good, keep it up.
I did okay. Yeah?
I see improvement. Boy.
It's some kind of drawing. Maybe a map?
Oh! Maybe a treasure map!
Which way to the chisel?
Keep rowing towards the statues of the oarsmen, then thread past between them.
Hey, Mimir. Last we were in a boat, we had just started the story. What did you want to tell me about the Long War?
Both sides suffered tremendous losses. And for many of us, quite frankly, war was simply no fun anymore. A rather senseless waste of precious life. And we'll pick this up later.
Roma!
Gulfig. Taken from this realm too early.
You who walks among the living, my beloved Gulfig calls to me. She yearns for peace, yet her remains lie in pieces. I beg of you, make my Gulfig whole again.
You want us to collect her bones? Gross.
Gulfig's Sather magic knows no bounds. She can reunite you with those you've lost.
Really? How?
Boy.
I can smell your grief, child. Rest assured, her magic is strong enough to create bridges between life and death. If only for a short while.
Boy, we are leaving.
They've taken three of Sweet Gulfig's bones and spread them across the lake. Bring me her bones, child. Gulfig will reward you.
Good. The special chisel is ahead, past this gate.
Focus up, boy!
Wait. bones.
Why?
Didn't you hear him? We could talk to Mom again. If we keep an eye out while we...
Look if you wish, boy. I will not be distracted by this fool's errand. This chisel we seek, what is it?
I'm glad you asked, actually. I have just the story for you. There was a giant once named Thamur. A very giant giant. Who, despite his mountainous size, was without question the greatest stonemason this world had ever seen. Proud Thamur hoped to one day pass his vast knowledge onto his son. But young Hrimthur had the heart of a warrior. Perhaps the father had too much fear in him, or the son too little. Either way, a quarrel of theirs spiraled out of control, and the overworked stonemason, bonk, struck his son. Hrimthur ran off into the night. Feeling shame and regret, Thamur chased after his son, but in his emotional state soon found himself wandering Midgard, lost and alone. Sadly, he caught the eye of the one person he didn't want to meet alone that night, so far from home. Thor.
And? What happened next?
You'll see.
Thor killed him. Oh no. He fell in the village?
Aye. When Thamur fell, he crushed a charming place famed for worshipping the Vanir god Njord. Thor always took credit for planning that one. The truth is, the sweaty ballbag just got lucky.
A wolver!
A dangerous beast. We will take him down together.
Giant chisel.
Darn, that didn't seem to do anything.
Brother, looks like that crystal's brimming again. Neat trick, lad.
Thanks. His idea.
Oh, Thamur was a frost giant. When he died, his final breath froze everything.
It's magically locked.
Atreus, here.
Find the tip of that chisel. That's the magic we need.
I like crystal base, but where's the crystal?
Prepare yourself!
How are we getting down there?
I have a plan.
You do?
Do not act so surprised.
Oh, no offense, brother, but I don't even think Thor with Mjolnir in hand could get through that much ice.
Then Thor is a fool.
This should be entertaining.
Boy.
Ready.
Slow!
Fire!
Again. Come on up! Wow, that was something, that fight. Here, catch!
Well, that was a waste of a perfectly good apple.
How were you not seen? There is nowhere here to hide.
Oh, that. It's a little trick my people can pull. A special way of not being seen.
You can be invisible?
More like I can step into the realm between realms. And your mind doesn't understand what it's seeing, so it sees nothing at all. That's how we avoid ever having to actually use the weapons we craft. It doesn't seem to work on dragons, though.
Your brother wanted to know if you're getting enough to eat. I guess I could tell him you are.
Brock was asking about me?
Was there meat on his breath?
You let him touch this again.
Come on, then.
So that's how Brock was in the temple right after the water drop. He stepped between realms.
Okay, now, shush! I need complete silence for this. There you go. Where shall we begin?
Oh, nothing. Okay.
So, this plan of yours.
Can you guess it?
Knowing you, it doesn't involve stinging. Around here.
Correct.
But how do we move forward?
Right here!
We heading into that building?
Yes.
You think there's something inside that'll help us break the ice and get to the chisel tip?
No.
I'll keep thinking.